back to the time he came to earth as a baby on Christmas morning long ago, as we prepare our hearts to receive him this Christmas, and as we look ahead to his coming again in glory when he comes to establish his kingdom in all its fullness on earth.
The Advent wreath is a circle with no beginning and no end, just as God's love has no beginning and no end. The light from the candles reminds us that Jesus is the light of the world. The light of Christ shines in the darkness, and the darkness cannot overcome it. The first candle is the candle of hope. Our hope is in the Lord, in his promises given to us, in his word, and in Jesus, in whom we have the promise of salvation and the assurance of our hope for eternal life in heaven with the Lord.
Let us pray. Merciful Lord, we thank you for the hope we have in you. We thank you that all of your promises have their yes for us in Jesus, in whom we trust for the forgiveness of our sins and the promise of heaven. Help us to seek to honor and worship you, and to show our love for you as we love and serve others in your name. Amen.
Amen.
Blessed be God, Father, Son, and Holy Spirit.
And blessed be his kingdom, now and forever. Amen.
Praying together. Almighty God, to you all hearts are open, all desires known, and from you no secrets are hid. Cleanse the thoughts of our hearts by the inspiration of your Holy Spirit, that we may perfectly love you and worthily magnify your holy name, through Christ our Lord. Amen. Holy God, holy and mighty, holy immortal one, have mercy upon us. The Lord be with you.
And also with you.
Let us pray. Almighty God, give us grace to cast away the works of darkness and put on the armor of light now in the time of this mortal life in which your Son, Jesus Christ, came to visit us in great humility, that at the last day when he shall come again in his glorious majesty to judge both the living and the dead, we may rise to the life immortal through him who lives and reigns with you in the Holy Spirit, one God, now and forever. Amen.
A reading from the book of the prophet Isaiah. Oh, that you would tear open the heavens and come down, so that the mountains would quake at your presence. As when fire kindles brushwood, and the fire causes water to boil, to make your name known to your adversaries, so that the nations might tremble at your presence. When you did awesome deeds that we did not expect, you came down. The mountains quaked at your presence. From ages past, no one has heard, no ear has perceived, no eye has seen any God beside you, who works for those who wait for him. You meet those who gladly do right, those who remember you in your ways. But you were angry, and we sinned. Because you hid yourself, we transgressed. We have all become like one who is unclean, and all our righteous deeds are like a filthy cloth. We all fade like a leaf, and our iniquities like the wind take us away. There is no one who calls on your name or attempts to take hold of you. For you have hidden your face from us and have delivered us into the hand of our iniquity. Yet, O Lord, you are our Father. We are the clay and you our potter. We're all the work of your hand. Do not be exceedingly angry, O Lord, and do not remember iniquity forever. Now consider, we are all your people. the word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
The psalm today is Psalm 80. Hear, O shepherd of Israel, leading Joseph like a flock. Shine forth, you that are enthroned upon the cherubim. In the presence of Ephraim, Benjamin, and Manasseh, stir up your strength and come to help us. Restore us, O God of hosts. Show the light of your countenance, and we shall be saved. O Lord God of hosts, how long will you be angered despite the prayers of your people? You have fed them with the bread of tears. You have given them bowls of tears to drink. You have made us the derision of our neighbors, and our enemies laugh us to scorn. Restore us, O God of hosts. Show the light of your countenance, and we shall be saved. Let your hand be upon the man of your right hand, the son of man you have made so strong for yourself. And so will we never turn away from you. Give us life that we may call upon your name. Restore us, O Lord God of hosts. Show the light of your countenance, and we shall be saved. A reading from the first letter of Paul to the Corinthians. Grace to you and peace from God our Father and the Lord Jesus Christ. I give thanks to my God always for you because of the grace of God that has been given you in Christ Jesus. For in every way you have been enriched in Him, in speech and knowledge of every kind. Just as the testimony of Christ has been strengthened among you, so that you are not lacking in any spiritual gift, as you wait for the revealing of our Lord Jesus Christ. He will also strengthen you to the end, so that you may be blameless on the day of our Lord Jesus Christ. God is faithful. By Him you will call into the fellowship of His Son, Jesus Christ our Lord. The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
Holy Gospel of our Lord and Savior Jesus Christ according to Mark.
Glory to you, Lord Christ.
Jesus said, "But in those days after that suffering, the sun will be darkened, and the moon will not give its light, and the stars will be falling from heaven, and the powers in the heavens will be shaken." Then they will see the Son of Man coming in clouds with great power and glory. Then he will send out the angels and gather his elect from the four winds, from the ends of the earth to the ends of heaven. From the fig tree, learn its lesson. As soon as its branch becomes tender and puts forth its leaves, you know that summer is near. So also, when you see these things taking place, you know that he is near at the very gates. Truly, I tell you, this generation will not pass away until all these things have taken place. Heaven and earth will pass away, but my words will not pass away. But about that day or hour, no one knows, neither the angels in heaven nor the Son, but only the Father. Beware, keep alert, for you do not know when the time will come. It is like a man going on a journey, when he leaves home and puts his slaves in charge, each with his work, and commands the doorkeeper to be on watch. Therefore, keep awake, for you do not know when the master of the house will come, in the evening, or at midnight, or at cockcrow, or at dawn, or else he may find you asleep when he comes suddenly. And what I say to you, I say to all, keep awake. The Gospel of the Lord.
Praise to you, Lord Christ.
May the words of my mouth and the meditations of our hearts be always acceptable in thy sight, O Lord, our strength and our Redeemer. Amen. In this age of information overload, it's becoming harder and harder to get our attention, especially if what's being presented isn't interesting to us or we think it's something we've heard before or already know. Let's be honest, unless we're terrified of flying, how many of us really pay attention during the safety briefing at the beginning of a flight? If you look around at other passengers while the flight attendant is giving instructions, you'll find they're doing anything but pay attention. They're reading, working, or watching something entertaining on their electronic device, looking out the window, doing a crossword puzzle, anything but paying attention. We've heard it all before. Fastening your seatbelt isn't rocket science, and besides, we assume, a plane crash isn't going to happen to us. If it does, we think we've heard it so many times before that we'll be ready. We'll know enough of what to do. Yet research has shown that the ability for passengers to recall safety information that's so critical in an emergency is extremely poor. So the airlines have gone all out trying to combat this jaded attitude, using humor, celebrities, anything to get our attention. In some cases, even spending millions on a single video. In one video in 2019, United Airlines partnered with Columbia Pictures to advertise the upcoming release of the movie Spider-Man: Far From Home, within the context of the safety instructions on their flights. In the video, Spider-Man captures a man with his web shooters and thrusts him into his seat, with a flight attendant then telling him how he should fasten his seatbelt. Perhaps the implication is that is what it would take to get our attention. One of the best presentations was done this year by the Australian Airlines Qantas, in which we're shown 100 years of flight history in a series of brief, historically accurate period scenes of passengers receiving various pieces of the safety instructions over the course of decades. Even the piece from the 1940s showed passengers looking out the window with a terribly bored expression on their face as the flight attendant explained how to fasten their seatbelts. Our failure to be alert is not unique to our time. For the last several weeks, our scripture readings have been warning us that the end times are coming, when Christ will return to bring judgment and establish the kingdom of God on earth. Today is the culmination of those warnings. It will be both glorious and terrible. For those who are the people of God, who have remained alert and are ready, It will be a glorious realization of justice and the redemption and restoration of the entire created order. For those who've turned away from the Lord, or who have been complacent and assume the time is not yet, who are not ready, it will be a terrible time of destruction and suffering. The elect that will be called together will come from all over the world, from various nations, peoples, races, and tongues. The same is true for those who will perish. So much time has passed since we were first given these warnings, it's easy to respond to them like those on an airplane when the flight attendant is giving flight instructions. We're tempted to assume it's information we won't need, and so we ignore the warning as if we've already got it covered and we'll be just fine. Jesus calls us to be on our guard. Be constantly alert. Watch and pray. For you do not know when the time will come. He said no one knows when that time is coming. The angels don't know. Even Jesus didn't know. Only the Father knows. The delay in the final judgment is because of the mercy of God, who wants all to have the opportunity to come to know him and be saved. But none of us knows when the end of our days will come. We all assume that the time is not yet, or we assume we will be ready when that day comes. Yet without the redeeming work of Christ at work in us, none of us are ready. The prophet Isaiah describes our spiritual state without Christ as being like a leper, unclean because of our sin and unfit to come into the presence of God. Even our best deeds of righteousness are like filthy rags compared to the righteousness of God. Without the grace of God, all of us would be headed for destruction. We struggle, we sin, we fail to pay attention, and we fall away. But God is faithful. God is reliable and trustworthy. God is merciful and has sent his Son, Jesus, to save us from the wrath that is to come and to call us back into relationship with him. It's not because of our own righteousness, but because of his righteousness given to us through the cross. Because of Jesus, we've exchanged our filthy rags for the white robes of righteousness that are the purity of Jesus Christ. He is the one who makes us holy and able to come into the presence of God. He is our hope for redemption. In Jesus Christ, we have the power of divine grace at work in our souls by the Holy Spirit. But it doesn't just happen by default while we're busy focusing on other things. We need to be alert, be spiritually awake, and on guard against being pulled into the ways of the world and a complacency in regard to our spiritual state of being. It is Jesus who will give us strength to remain faithful and keep us steadfast, even in those times when we become weary of the struggle or jaded by the waiting. He is our guarantee that we will be with him. But we need to give him our full attention while we wait and watch, living in hope for his coming again, when he will be made visible to all. He will be our advocate on the day of judgment, when he will say, "Yes, she's with me," or "He's with me." But for now, as we hold to that promise, we must keep awake. Amen.
We believe in one God, the Father, the Almighty, maker of heaven and earth, of all that is seen and unseen. We believe in one Lord Jesus Christ, the only Son of God, eternally begotten of the Father, God from God, light from light, true God from true God, begotten, not made, of one being with the Father. Through him all things were made. For us and for our salvation, he came down from heaven. By the power of the Holy Spirit, he became incarnate from the Virgin Mary and was made man. For our sake, he was crucified under Pontius Pilate. He suffered death and was buried. On the third day, he rose again in accordance with the scriptures. He ascended into heaven and is seated at the right hand of the Father. He will come again in glory to judge the living and the dead, and his kingdom will have no end. We believe in the Holy Spirit, the Lord, the giver of life, who proceeds from the Father and the Son. With the Father and the Son, he is worshiped and glorified. He has spoken through the prophets. We believe in one holy, Catholic, and apostolic church. We acknowledge one baptism for the forgiveness of sins. We look for the resurrection of the dead and the life of the world to come. Amen.
We give thanks for those who were confirmed this past weekend. For Susan Brown Allen, Emmett Stephen Ayers Jr., Georgia Alexandra Butler, Charles Richard Coleman, Catherine Coleman, Christopher Michael Hare, Evan Cantrell Hare, Casey Marie Hopper, Elijah Daniel Hopper, Matthew Thomas Hopper, William Rhett Hudson, Anderson O. Jones, Marissa Kathleen Marana, Anna Burns Myers, Lutricia Wright Richardson, Virginia Logan Ross, Ava Marguerite Stuckey, Andrew Johnson Sutherland Jr., Mildred Reeves Sutton, Bryce Anthony Whitley, Robert Eager Wilkin III. Renew in these your servants, O Lord, the covenant you made with them at their baptism. Send them forth in the power of that Spirit to perform the service you set before them. Through Jesus Christ, your Son, our Lord, who lives and reigns with you and the Holy Spirit, one God, now and forever. Amen.
The prayers of the people. Creator of the stars in the sky, the sun and the moon, you are the light by which we wake and work.
Illumine our darkness and keep us alert.
Surround your church, her leaders, and people with your armor of light. We pray especially for Michael Curry, our presiding bishop, Rob Wright, our bishop, Cynthia and Zac, our priests, and for all our staff and vestry. Strengthen them as they reach out to you in prayer and hope. Open their hearts to your will.
Illumine our darkness and keep us alert.
We pray for our leaders, especially Donald Trump, our president, Brian Kemp, our governor, and the Congress and courts of this land. Savior of the nations, guide those who govern and awaken those they lead, that we may all live in the spirit of cooperation and share so that all have enough food, care, and peace.
Illumine our darkness and keep us alert.
For people across the world whose spirits bend under the yoke of oppression and struggle, give the people of this community a sense of togetherness and support. Open our eyes to those who fall by the wayside and whose faces and needs remain invisible.
Illumine our darkness and keep us alert.
Lover of our souls, you continue to mold us in your image and hold us in your hands. We ask your blessing on those who struggle with illness, anxiety, grief, or isolation. We pray for Amanda, Ashley, Bailey, Brandy, Candy, Christy, Crawford, Elizabeth, George, Helen, Herkley, Hannah, Jay, Jane, Jennifer, John, Joyce, Libby, Linda, Kelly, Malcolm, Margaret, Mary, Mary Louise, Matthew, Melanie, Nancy, Pammy, Pat, Pete, Peter, Ray, Rob, Robert, Sandy, and Willie. For those serving in the military, Alan, Austin, Cameron, Charlie, George, Joe, John, Rose, and Thomas. For those serving abroad in mission work, especially Joe and Robin, John, Nancy, and the DeRiga family.
Illumine our darkness and keep us alert.
Father of us all, we pray for those who have recently returned to your embrace and those who are broken with grief. Please add your own prayers, either silently or aloud.
Hasten, O Father, the coming of your kingdom, and grant that we, your servants who now live by faith, may with joy behold your Son at his coming in glorious majesty, even Jesus Christ, our only mediator and advocate. Amen. Using the prayer on page 360, let us confess our sins against God and our neighbor. Most merciful God, we confess that we have sinned against you in thought, word, and deed, by what we have done and by what we have left undone. We have not loved you with our whole heart. We have not loved our neighbors as ourselves. We are truly sorry, and we humbly repent. For the sake of your Son, Jesus Christ, have mercy on us and forgive us, that we may delight in your will and walk in your ways, to the glory of your name. Amen. Almighty God, have mercy on you, forgive you all your sins through our Lord Jesus Christ, strengthen you in all goodness, and by the power of the Holy Spirit, keep you in eternal life. Amen. The peace of the Lord be always with you.
And also with you.
Yours, O Lord, is the greatness, the power, the glory, the victory, and the majesty. For everything in heaven and on earth is yours. Yours, O Lord, is the kingdom, and you are exalted as head over all.
Thank you.
service continues on page 361 of the Book of Common Prayer. The Lord be with you.
And also with you.
Lift up your hearts.
We lift them to the Lord.
Let us give thanks to the Lord our God.
It is right to give him thanks and praise.
It is right and a good and joyful thing, always and everywhere, to give thanks to you, Father Almighty, Creator of heaven and earth, because you sent your beloved Son to redeem us from sin and death, and to make us heirs in him of everlasting life, that when he shall come again in power and great triumph to judge the world, we may without shame or fear rejoice to behold his appearing. Therefore we praise you, joining our voices with angels and archangels, and with all the company of heaven, who forever sing this hymn to proclaim the glory of your name. Holy, holy, holy Lord, God of power and might, heaven and earth are full of your glory. Hosanna in the highest. Blessed is he who comes in the name of the Lord. Hosanna in the highest. Holy and gracious Father, in your infinite love you made us for yourself. And when we had fallen into sin and become subject to evil and death, you in your mercy sent Jesus Christ, your only and eternal Son, to share our human nature, to live and die as one of us, to reconcile us to you, the God and Father of all. He stretched out his arms upon the cross and offered himself in obedience to your will, a perfect sacrifice for the whole world. On the night he was handed over to suffering and death, our Lord Jesus Christ took bread. And when he had given thanks to you, he broke it and gave it to his disciples and said, "Take, eat. This is my body which is given for you. Do this for the remembrance of me." After supper, he took the cup of wine. And when he had given thanks, he gave it to them and said, "Drink this, all of you. This is my blood of the new covenant, which is shed for you and for many, for the forgiveness of sins. Whenever you drink it, do this for the remembrance of me." Therefore, we proclaim the mystery of faith. Christ has died. Christ is risen. Christ will come again. We celebrate the memorial of our redemption, O Father, in this sacrifice of praise and thanksgiving, recalling his death, resurrection, and ascension, we offer you these gifts. Sanctify them by the Holy Spirit to be for your people the body and blood of your Son, the holy food and drink of new and unending life in him. Sanctify us also that we may faithfully receive this holy sacrament and serve you in unity, constancy, and peace. And at the last day, bring us with all your saints into the joy of your eternal kingdom. All this we ask through your Son, Jesus Christ, by him and with him and in him, in the unity of the Holy Spirit. All honor and glory is yours, Almighty Father, now and forever. Amen. Now, as our Savior Christ has taught us, we are bold to say, Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. For thine is the kingdom, and the power, and the glory, forever and ever. Amen. Alleluia. Christ our Passover is sacrificed for us.
Therefore, let us keep the feast. Alleluia.
The gifts of God for the people of God. Using the prayer on page 365, let us pray. Eternal God, Heavenly Father, you have graciously accepted us as living members of your Son, our Savior, Jesus Christ, and you have fed us with spiritual food in the sacrament of his body and blood. Send us now into the world in peace, and grant us strength and courage to love and serve you with gladness and singleness of heart, through Christ our Lord. Amen. The peace of God, which passes all understanding, keep your hearts and minds in the knowledge and love of God and of his Son, Jesus Christ our Lord. And the blessing of the Almighty God, Father, Son, and Holy Spirit be among you and remain with you always. Amen.
Thank you.
in peace to love and serve the Lord.
Thanks be to God.